In a nation where threats of war constantly loom on the horizon, where official diplomacy with other nations is throttled and pushed in a corner, and where citizens want nothing but keeping their way of life and universal values, what a civilian can do in an event of war has become a pressing discussion in Taiwan's civil society today.
其实，在战争当中，大家很常看到一部分就是直接的这个从事战斗的任务嘛，哈。其中台湾这块非常欠缺，原因就是因为大家对于枪械的了解非常的少。台湾是一个禁枪的国家，没办法去有取得这样的工具去自我的训练，或是说建立一个防卫的信心，然后。
Without access to firearms, what are meaningful ways a concerned citizen can engage in guarding their motherland?This is not an underground arsenal. Ostensibly, it is near impossible to distinguish them from the real firearms.
台湾的玩具枪，也就是所谓的 airsoft 啊，那其实占了全世界的70%啊以上。像法国啊，军方啊，像荷兰啊，他们警方啊，那像日本警视厅等等啊，那这些他们要训练的时候。他们也需要这些 airsoft 作为一个训练的 device， 啊，那他们也来使用台湾的玩具枪作为训练。
But how can airsoft help people get a hang of gun handling？
IDPA 其实是国际防卫手枪协会的缩写，哦，那 IDPA 从1996年开始到现在已经超过25年以上的历史。最早是我的老师 Ken Hudson 跟 Larry Vickers 他们啊。他们是第一批的创始会员，一直到现在。
In September 2022, a team of four Taiwanese seasoned airsoft shooters weathered the absence of real gun training and embarked upon the long-distance flight to Colorado, the U.S. For what? For the national championship by International Defensive Pistol Association. And this is their story.
大家就上弹，然后就当比赛一样，右边这边就是只有空枪可以用，直接把。都在哦。
其实很，心里面压力是很大的，那尤其是第一次代表台湾去参加这个世界级的最高殿堂的 IDPA 的竞赛，其实。心里就大家对你的期待是很高的，希望去的人都可以拿奖牌回来。
叶建廷 ，He works in the semiconductor industry in Hsinchu, Taiwan, part of the global supply chain of chips. In 2020 IDPA Taiwan, he won the first place in masterclass of enhanced service pistol, and in 2021 IDPA Taiwan, the first place in masterclass of compact carry pistol.
这个位置还是在。上面
教官，你直接打，你直接打，
直接打就知道。
Aaron， 接板。1161。
Airsoft 转换成真枪啊，实际上它只有两个地方要克服的：音爆声，第二就是后坐力。我们很幸运的是，现在的玩具枪啊，实际上它后坐力做到已经算大了，破坏射手的瞄准图形已经做得很不错。
沈志亮 ，A Coast Guard Administration veteran who used to be a weapons instructor, today is his everyday ritual, putting on a bulletproof vest, carrying four magazines, running up and down the stairs, and doing weight training.Now he's the head engineer of an airsoft service center in New Taipei City. With IDPA, he won the first place in masterclass of pistol caliber carbine in 2020 and second place in 2021 IDPA Taiwan.
Wow,
Are you ready? Stand by. Oh. Hey, okay, 好 ，I'll launch you quick. Okay.
我现在接下来要讲的这个东西呢，是跟眼镜有关系。
Frank Shi is a Taiwanese-American competition shooter in Utah. With his intensive instruction on the transition, the four shooters expedite their grasp on the real pistols.
Okay, 大家有看到吗？你的枪比你的手、比你的肌肉还要快很多。只要你的动作做对了，就算你扣板已经扣了，你才去压的话，它还是重。Okay.
要
啊！为什么
过
头了吗？
哎呀，我的轮罩，我觉得应该可以命中，但是他没有命中。
你稍等一下啊。哎，再一次。
其实一方面就是自己的小孩刚出生，然后在这几个月当中一直处于没有办法好好休息的一个状况，但是我们又要努力的抓出这个很破碎的时间，让自己去想说啊，如果我真的遇到真枪的情况下，我应该怎么去应对。
郑家华 ，a father of two, including a newborn, he's an educator, a chemistry teacher, and a junior high school in Taipei. He has been the national champion of IDPA Taiwan for 3 years since 2019, to name a few.
掉一颗啊！3.86，休息一下。
这也应该也是我们台湾第一次去参加这种最高等级的这样的国外性的比赛，所以你真的能够做到哪一种程度？说实话，心里没有一个底。
王茂珍 ，a violinist and composer by trade, he wears many hats. Formerly a pilot.Now a sea captain and member of New Taipei City Volunteer Rescue Squad. In 2021 IDPA Taiwan, he won the first place in masterclass of stock service pistol, also an IDPA safety officer.
Yeah, Jawa, you can真枪跟 airsoft 还是有点不一样，所以可能有些动作可能大家要去习惯一下，但没有关系，还有3天。那我现在接下来要
讲 jet lag, unfamiliar desert climate, and an altitude of 1,600 meters. And as if it's not hard enough, for 郑家华 COVID takes a toll on his health.
昨天9点多就睡觉了，然后睡到12点起来，全身发热，然后流汗，心跳变快，睡不着。即使是躺在床上，再怎么深呼吸，吸氧气罐，还是睡不着。跨越半个地球来到这边，然后家里那边呢，同事们都确诊。然后家人也确诊，很担心自己的小孩也确诊，希望可以有更好的结果了。
在那个当下，因为遇到非常多的挫折，因为真枪跟气枪的转换，然后身体的确诊，然后导致你的所有力量判断能力都下降，然后你又有濒临比赛的紧张感，众多的冲击其实是非常非常容易让你觉得我到底来这边干什么？但是我觉得在那当下，就是你得不断的告诉自己。你做得到，我的队友们越打越好，我也可以越打越好。就算我身体有点问题、有点状况，我也要跟上他们。我觉得出去让我最在这边也是非常感动一点，就是我们觉得我们是一个团队，我们是台湾来的团队，然后我们要努力的一起打好这个目标。
The clock is ticking for their transitioning to the real guns during the run-up to the competition.
好很多了。
预备。
一开始就是这个扳机没有办法控制得很好，然后 grab 没有办法 grab 很好，因为我们亚洲人的这个握力板就是比较小，所以到现在为止已经改善很多了，就是知道怎么样把它压得够紧，让枪不要跳得这么严重。其实现在可以控制到都可以打在 A rock 里面，算是很好。
Between 800 and 1,000 rounds are fired by each shooter every day.The firm foundation of gun handling cultivated by Airsoft, coupled with masses of live rounds in this intensive training, builds their confidence.
我觉得自己打得好不好，我觉得这是我自己的压力。可是我觉得现在更大的压力是国旗能不能够在舞台上。
开始了，预备。
D-Day.
Ready to call it all day. Thank you. One of the best. Thank you for this gathering. Just keep them all safe. Keep them from harm. God for God, we live in our nation. Please help us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Keep everything safe and holy. Thank you, King Jesus. Precious son. Thank you. Amen.
Slow is smooth. Smooth is fast.
Are you ready?
There are 16 stages for older shooters plus Deacon's drill. Their performance will finally be tested on the clock. Upon their hearing the beep, a sense of honor, determination, and patriotism are fired through the swooshes of rounds on targets.They know fairly well the expectation of many Taiwanese, and they carry on.
IDPA 是考验自己，你在射击的速度跟准度如何去平衡？
我们要怎么去控制它这么大的强大的后坐力？然后我们要去怎么障碍排除这个东西？可能是对我们来说比较不熟。
You guys are training with Airsoft,
yes.
And then came out here, did a couple of days of training before the match, and I just have to say, on top of everyone just being the nicest, friendliest, happiest squad I think we've ever been with, like they're shooting amazing. You know, it really has blown me and Chris away. Just like how everyone's gun handling is so good, you know, everybody's shooting well. It's very impressive.
对于安全的理解跟你对于这支枪的操控的能力，其实基本上我们跟实弹的射手是没有两样的。
其实最感动的地方，第一个就是升旗的时候，当我们国家的国旗在，我真的会哭出来。所以那是一般人没办法去体会，我们一个职业军人
其实台湾遇到的困境就是我们在外面的运动比赛，我们只能升会旗，我们没有办法升起自己的国旗。 但我们这样去跟这个靶场主持人讲的时候，他就说那 OK， 我们来升台湾国旗。我觉得那个当下那个冲击感很大，就是人家是把你当，就是靶场的设施主持人知道你是一个国家，他也愿意把你当一回事。我觉得这样的对待是最感动的时刻。我们把国旗就留在这边了，他承诺我们只要还有台湾人去打这个比赛，他会帮我们再升起这面国旗。
Relying on his gunsmith literacy and dexterity, Chen Zhiliang won the first place in marksman class of Enhanced Service Pistol, ESP, and was most accurate shooter using iron sights. Through an emotional roller coaster, Ye Jianting won the third place in marksman class of Enhanced Service Pistol, ESP. Bouncing back from COVID infection, Zheng Jiahua won the second place in sharpshooter class of Stock Service Pistol, SSP, and was high international using iron sights. Counting on his versatility and laser-sharp aiming, Wang Maozhen won the first place in marksman class of carry optics.
You know, I'm a little worried that our friends from Taiwan, their luggage is going to be too heavy on the way back. All these
When the lights are off and curtain is lowered, life carries on back home. In different corners, they play their roles to keep Taiwan society we dearly cherish rolling. Just like every citizen, however small a cog in a large wheel he or she may be. It is the efforts of Taiwanese, collectively, to put Taiwan continuously as a liberal and open nation on a world map. The four shooters are the ordinary doing the extraordinary. They symbolize a beam of hope, taking the challenge in their stride, and above all, against the odds. And it is because of this spirit and character of perseverance and resilience, Taiwan's national flag continues flying.
在我的观点里面，我觉得人生而可贵，是因为你有能力选择。可是选择之前，你必须要有能力，你才能选。那如果今天你没有能力，你就没有选择的权利。那在于我们以后的国防，是不是一般民众都应该拿着枪上战场？我不这么认为。我认为，可能他是一个IT 的工程师，他可以做好非常棒的事情，胜过他拿枪。但是如果他不知道这个事情的危险，他就会带来更多的灾难。好，所以我会希望从我们已经是一个民主自由的国家，国家这么大这么长的历程。我觉得可以让民众多一点学习，去了解他可能以后会面临的危险。那我觉得射击运动是一个好的开始。
很多人会批评说啊，玩具枪只是一个玩具啦，它不会有训练效果。可是我们不再需要去用很多的逻辑啦，很多理论去说明为什么可行，而是透过这一次的案例，很清楚的。使用 Airsoft 做出来的训练，的确让你可以得到一个最基本个人的使用枪械的知识跟技术。
在参与竞赛当中，这个计时的感觉会让我觉得生活当中充满了真实。所以我觉得你一旦参与竞赛，你体验到那个逼声响起之后的感觉，你就很难再放下去。
IDPA， 你看这四个字组成就是国际防卫手枪协会嘛，既然叫做防卫手枪，就是要保护自己，保护家人。
借由不断的去训练，那大家的这种战斗意识提高了，那自然而然每个人如此，那你全民国防的能力就出来了。好，那所以说其实这个是一个对全民国防来讲，它是一个很好的一个工具。好，我们是这样子去看待。